Dr. Rupa Iyengar here. Today I will be talking about breast diseases in gynecology. Breast diseases in women include both benign and malignant conditions. Patients often present with the complaints of breast pain or abnormal nipple discharge. They may also complain of feeling a palpable mass or maybe enlargement of breast. The evaluation of breast diseases in women includes taking careful history, doing proper physical examination, appropriate imaging of the breast, and appropriate sampling of the tissue. Majority of the breast diseases occur in females, but the male sex is not exempt. Most breast diseases in young women are benign, but with advancement of age, benign problems of the breast give way to malignant conditions. Women with benign breast lumps are apprehensive that the mass might be a cancerous one. Careful counseling supported by confirmed histological diagnosis often relieves this anxiety. Breast starts developing at 6 to 8 weeks of gestation from a longitudinal ectodermal ridge which extends from axilla to groin. Any accessory breast tissue will be seen on this longitudinal line. Next period of growth is at puberty under the influence of estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen will cause the ductal proliferation, whereas progesterone affects the development of alveoli and glandular tissue. Further changes in the breast is seen during pregnancy. The breast extends from 2nd to 6th rib in mid-clavicular line. An extension in the axilla may be present, which is known as axillary tail of the breast. These glandular bilateral structures produce milk after childbirth. Anatomy of the breast. The breasts are specialized glandular tissue which produce milk, and it also contains fatty tissue. 15 to 29 lobes made up of milk-producing lobules are arranged radially from central nipple, which is surrounded by areola, which is pigmented skin. Lobules have network of ducts opening in the areola. As you can see here, breasts are containing fatty tissue and the ducts, fibrous tissue. Nipple is almost in the center, surrounded by areola, and there are axillary lymph nodes which drain lymphatics from breast majorly. Here you can see the structure of the breast. This is a lobule on the right side, then ducts, fatty tissue and blood vessels, and there is a fibrous tissue supporting the lobules. Lymphatic drainage of the breast. Majorly, the lymphatic drainage is in axillary lymph nodes. The upper part of the breast will drain the supraclavicular nodes, whereas medial part drains into internal mammary lymph nodes. Some of the lower portion of the breast lymphatics drain into abdominal and mediastinal lymph nodes. Blood supply of the breast is by perforating branches of internal mammary artery, also branches from intercostal arteries. Certain branches of axillary artery like thoracic artery and thoracoacromial artery also give the blood supply to the breast tissue. Whenever a patient comes with any complaint regarding breast, we should take a very careful history. Complaint of pain or discomfort, we should ask about the onset, duration and progress of this pain. Is it associated or not associated with menstruation? Character of the pain. And is there complaint of any lump or discharge from the nipple? Also, find out if she had any history of trauma or any strenuous activity. Now next important complaint may be lump. When the lump is complained of, we have to ask, when did she notice lump first? And also consistency of the lump. Next, I'll ask about nipple discharge. If there is nipple discharge, what is the duration of the nipple discharge, the color and quantity, and the nature of the discharge. If there is any associated pain, and is it a unilateral or bilateral discharge? Is it from single duct or multiple duct? And any associated mass if it is there. Also, whether the patient is premenopausal or postmenopausal. And if she has any history of drug intake like phenothiazine. And ask about any other significant history. On examination, if there is a lump, we have to find out the details of the lump, the consistency of the lump, the location of the lump, and the size and shape of the lump. Also, whether it is well-defined lump and is there any mobility present in the lump. Tenderness also should be examined. And find out if there is any dimpling of the skin and any discharge of the nipple. That also needs to be found out. And we should always examine the axillary tail of the breast and find out if any lymph nodes are palpable. This is about the history and examination. Now there are various types of diseases of breast which we will discuss. There are some congenital abnormalities of the breast. Then sometimes there is a mastalgia or painful breast. Another disease of breast is fibroadenoma. Then there is a benign cystic disease. Also breast cysts. Then abnormal nipple discharge is some of the complaints. Then maybe diagnosis of mastitis. Then nipple and breast itchiness is one more complaint. And there could be breast lump. Now congenital breast diseases. There could be supernumerary nipple or supernumerary areola. This is known as polythelia. Then there could be supernumerary or extra breast tissue, polymastia or polymasia. There may be absence of nipple or absence of areola, that is athelia. Absence of breast is known as amastia or amasia. Then there may be small breast, that is hypoplasia. And there could be a complaint of asymmetrical breast tissue. One breast is developed normally and another may be smaller or bigger. Then there is a complaint of excessively large or hypertrophied breast. You can see some of the pictures. Here, this lady, left side, is having hypoplasia of the left breast. And the next one is hypoplasia of the right breast, or it is an asymmetrical development of breasts. Then this is polythelia. There is an extra nipple, as you can see. Supernumerary nipple is present. This is a polymasia, that is extra breast tissue is present. So, what is the treatment for this? The treatment for small breast is actually cosmetic surgery, and same thing applies to the large breasts also. Unless the development is less because of the absence of hormones, in that case both breasts will be less developed generally. In that case we can give them supplement of hormones, estrogen and combined hormones, estrogen and progesterone.